iro3d is a low-cost 3D printer that prints solid, 100% dense, precise and strong metal objects. It uses selective powder deposition process, SPD for short. SPD is explained in details in our other videos, but basically you selectively pour, build and support powders into a crucible. Add an infill metal and bake it in a kiln. Let's look at each step. Here we pour metal powder, but you don't see much because the crucible is opaque. Let's take a petri dish and pretend for a second it's a crucible. Here we can see how the powders are selectively deposited. When we finish filling the whole crucible, we add an infill metal. With coke. And some sand. Close it with a lid. And bake it in a kiln. The temperature in the kiln should be above the melting temperature of the infill metal, but below the melting temperature of the powder. When the infill metal melts, it soaks the metal powder, so there are no porosities in the printed object. But infill metal doesn't soak the support powder, because the support powder, sand in our case, is not wettable by the molten infill metal. Note that SPD doesn't use sintering, so there is no shrinkage and no shape distortion associated with it. When it cools down, we remove it from the kiln and clean it up with a wire brush or a sandblaster. In theory, SPD can be used with any metals. Actually, the printer itself is material agnostic and can pour any powder that flows through a small hole. But when it comes to choosing the kiln, some metals are easier than others. Metals that are not oxidizable by carbon oxide, such as iron, copper, silver, gold, nickel, platinum, would work with air atmosphere kilns. But other metals, like aluminum, stainless, titanium, would require a kiln with controlled atmosphere, like vacuum and nitrogen or argon. The slicer software, iro3d, is fairly easy to use. You connect to the printer. You select the file you need to print. Most settings you can leave at defaults. Just make sure you have the right crucible shape and size. Then slice Look at the preview. You can use either keyboard or mouse. And send it to the printer. As for the maximum size of the printed object, the current version can print something around 30 by 30 by 10 centimeters. But it looks like this size is too much for home use and too little for industrial applications. So it looks like we'll be making a smaller version for DIY folks sometime in the future. But for now, in addition to the current size, we're taking orders for custom-sized printers. For more information, go to iro3d.com. Here we have the specs. Here are the frequently asked questions. Please look at them before asking. Here is our YouTube channel. Here we have some general videos. And here are the tutorials that explain how to use iro3d printer in details. And here are two picture galleries. One with the photos of the printer. And the other one with the 3D printed objects.